So that is the thing I told you. So this is co-proprietary. Number of STP instances depends on the number of VLANs. For every VLAN, a BBD is generated. Right? Every VLAN, a BBD will be generated, and every VLAN will be having one BPDU, one root bridge for itself. Okay. Every VLAN will be having one root bridge. That is why we call it as per VLAN spanning tree. Okay. Effective where load sharing is required. In the example, we have shared the load onto all the switches. That is the thing he's saying. Effective where load sharing is required. BBDU sent for each VLAN. Rapid convergence. Convergence will be rapid. That is topology convergence. Stable. It will be stable within no time.
Okay.
Just like see. This is my physical topology. Okay. Actually, for suppose this link is down. This link is down. Again, to make this link up in CST, the time consumes more. But whereas in PVST, it will be faster. That is the thing is rapid convergence. Convergence is making the topology stable. If one link is down, immediately making the other link up is called convergence. Redundancy. So rapid convergence and both the encapsulations ISL and IEEE 802.2 are supported. I told you encapsulation. Consumes resources because of the control traffic overhead. There is no much point. So in order to configure and monitor PVST, show spanning tree. In order to verify, show spanning tree. And show spanning tree VLAN, VLAN ID. Show spanning tree route. This will tell you. Show spanning tree will tell you. Whatever the VLANs you have. For all the VLAN spanning tree, whatever the spanning tree configuration is, it will be shown. Show spanning tree. Okay, behavior of all the VLANs. And if you are specifying VLAN and VLAN ID, only for that specific VLAN ID, the spanning tree convergence or the spanning tree output will be shown. And show spanning tree route, it will show the root bridge, who is the root bridge for that specific VLAN, for that specific spanning tree. Show spanning tree blocked ports. This command will show you the what are all the blocked ports on that switch by spanning tree. We'll see the practical. Implementing PVST is very simple. Okay. Okay, so implementing span tree PVST is very simple. Conferring per VLAN, conferring priority. First, let us see how to confer priority. Right, just actually, this must be entered in the configuration mode. Yep. So this will be our configuration, whatever we need to do. Span entry, VLAN, for what VLAN you wanted to change the priority. That VLAN, VLAN ID, priority, and give whatever priority you want. Okay. And span entry, VLAN, VLAN ID. Instead of giving priority manually, if you want to change it automatically, if the switch has to take the decision of the priority, give this as root primary. If you are giving this command, switch will itself calculate the priority and it will make the switch as root. Okay. And span entry, VLAN, VLAN ID, root secondary. This is also to dynamically assign the priority.